Hi students, now let us see the another very important concept of the arithmetic progression chapter. So here this is our fourth video on this concept, and in this video I take the very important concept, that is the sum of the n terms of an AP. Okay, so here we are finding the sum of all the terms. So we know that the number of terms are AP, okay, that is n is equal to number of terms, okay, in the formula an is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d, where n stand for the number of terms. So we observe that in the many problems, okay, in the three videos we solve many problems. Then the many problems observe that there are so many terms are there. In some case 10 terms are there, 25 terms are there, 30 terms are there, 100 terms are there. Okay, now in this concept we have learned about what are the sum of all these numbers. For example, see, if I write a sequence, okay, that is AP 1 2 3 4 5 up to the 4 up to the 10. Okay, so if I add all numbers, what I get? So the one method is common method is you have to write all one, okay, that is 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 plus 6 plus 7 plus 8 plus 9 plus 10. Then we add and we say that sum is equal to how much? We can write the 3 3 6, okay, 10 15 21, okay, 28, then 36, okay, 36, here 46, 46 plus 9 is 45, okay, like that. So that is take heavy time and heavy number up to 10. If one ask what is the sum of 1 plus 2 plus 3 up to 1000, so it is difficult to sum all the numbers, okay, it take consume the time, okay, it consume our time. So now we have to find another method by using which we are easily find out the sum of the all the numbers in the number which are present in the AP. So that is called as n, sum of the n terms of AP. If there are 5 terms are there, 10 terms are there, or 100 terms are there, in a second we can calculate that sum of all the terms, okay, but this method can consume the time. Okay, we get correct answer, but it take the time. Up to 10 we can make easily, okay, up to 20 we can add easily, but what about 100? If someone asks you, right, what is the sum of numbers when you add from 1 to 1000, means you have first write up to 1000 table and then you add one by one, so that consume actually really very time. So that is why we use a short method, okay, use a formula by using which we are easily find out the sum of all the terms, any terms, 1000 term, 2000 sum, lakh together, we easily find in a second, and that formula is called as sum of n terms of an AP, and the formula represented by SN. Okay, so SN is stand for summation of or sum of an nth term. Okay, so E is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. So this is the formula to calculate the sum of the all the terms present in the AP. Condition is that must be AP, the sequence must be AP. Okay, let's see here one by one the meaning of terms. So here see where SN is stand for summation of or sum of nth term. Okay, n, okay, see nth, not n terms, okay, n terms, or terms maybe 2 3 4 5 6, anything, that is n terms. Okay, SN stand for, and the n stand for simple, as we know in the formula an is equal to a plus n minus 1 to d, n is stand for number of terms, right? You are right, that is a number of terms. Okay, and then we get a. So what is a here? See, right, that is what, the first term of an AP, first term of an AP. Okay, first term of an AP. And what is n? Okay, again repeated, same, n is nothing but number of terms. What is d? Right, so d is an common difference. Okay, common difference. So these are, student, very important point you have to remember. Okay, so what is mean by these all terms you have to remember, then only you are able to solve the problems. Okay, so what is SN? Sum of the n terms. Okay, in the examination they ask what is the sum of an given term, means you have to write this formula, sum of an given terms, with 10 terms, 20 terms. Okay, later on we solve the problem, so one by one get the use of the how to use this formula. Okay, so these are actually what about the summation of n number of terms. Okay, now let us see, I can slight change this formula, right? See, I can write here this formula like that. Okay, right here, that is SN is equal to, okay, as it is n by 2, right? So 2, I can break 2a into a plus a. Okay, this is right. I can break 2a into a plus a. A plus a again 2a. okay, and as it is, that is n minus 1 into d. So see here, as it is n by 2, okay, a, so what is this one? See, what is this? You know this formula. What is this? This is nothing but what? This is nothing but an formula. That is what? An is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. What is an? An is the nth term, or also called as a n. An is equal to last term. That is last term. Okay, that is represented by L. So if an is the last term, then we have to write as al is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. So means that an is nothing but what? Last term. So replace that one. So here see a. So this a plus n minus 1 d nothing but what? An. Okay, nothing but an. So when they argue the last term, we use this formula. When they argue the last term also, we use this formula. Or this also written as summation of n is equal to n by 2 into, is there into, most of the student write here plus, no, n by 2 into is there. Most of the student what do? Their by mistake they find plus, write plus here. So that is big mistake they done. That is here into is there. Okay. So to n by 2 into n by 2 into a plus, in the place of right, if a is the last term, I can use l. Okay. So this also formula which is very important. When we use these for both formula, when they give last term. Okay. When in the question there is a last term is given, when directly we use this formula. Or also we use this formula, we get the answer. There is no problem. If you, it is directly, okay, directly. Okay, how it is used? How do we identify, use this formula? Okay, next questions, we use so many times this formula. If you also use, if the last term given and you use this formula means, then also you get the same answer. There is no problem, okay? So that is both are give same answer, but it is somewhat save your time, okay? Short is, two step is less here, okay? Here two step is more, but it is save your time. Okay, let us see one by one in which situation we use this formula, in which situation we use this formula. So one by one we learn by solving the number of problems. Okay, so again in this video I solve nearly 6 to 7 problems and see how we get a use of this formula and find the number of sum of a number of terms and how the questions are asked on these concepts. Okay, so please write down these all concepts, this one formula. And by this formula modify into this type, okay, a plus 2a's break into a plus a, so we get a and this formula, okay, then I can change, okay, so there are three formulas, one this set and one is modified into these two sets, okay, one time an or an sometimes last term al, both are same. So please take pause the video and write down these all concepts. Okay students, now take the first example, that is here, find the sum of the first 24 terms of an AP. Okay, see here, AP is given and given AP and 24 terms, we have to find the sum. Okay, so solution is, see here, first write down AP. Okay, given AP is, there is 5, 8, 11 and 14 dashed. Okay, now let us see what is formula we use here. So that is SN, because of find the sum of n 24 terms. So SN is equal to n by 2 into 2A plus n minus 1 into d, right? Now let us see, put the values. So what we require, see, we require n, we require a and we require d. So what is n here? So n is equal to given, that is 24 terms, okay, here 24 terms. Let's, while we require a, so what is a? A is equal to 5, first term, and what is d here? So find difference, anything, 8 minus 5 or something, 8 minus 5, 8, 11 minus 8, all is same, okay? So 5 is equal to 3. So now put the values. So yes, 24 is equal to summation of 24. So 24 by 2 is equal to 2 times of a is equal to 5 plus n is 24 minus 1 and d is equal to 3. Okay, now let us see 24 by 2 is the 12. Okay, then 2, 5, that 10 plus here 23 into 3. Okay, now solve it, 1, 12 into 10 plus, okay, 3, 3 is a 9, 3, 2 is a 6, 69. So we get how much here? So 12 into, so 69 plus 10 is equal to 79. So now multiply, how much you get? 79 into 12. 2, 8 is 18, 2, 9 is 18, 2, 14 is 15, plus 1, 1, 9, so 1, 7. So we get 8, 14 and here 9. So how much we get? 9, 48. So the sum of 24 7 term is
that is now 948.
Okay, so this is what simple solution of the first example, right? So this is we get how we use the formula, right? It is direct, it is simple one, it is about a 2 marks question. It is important for 2 marks direct question. Most of the time they ask like that. Okay, simple one, they give n value, in the sequence we can find A, in the sequence we can find D, and simply put we get the solution. Okay, so here pause the video and write the solution. Okay, right, now take example 2 here, similar example. Example 2, which is a board exam question, that is find sum that is 25 plus 28 plus 31 and plus so on plus 100 up to 100. Okay, up to 100, that is again important question. See here, in this question what problem is there? What problem is there? Here they not give value of n here, right? How many terms are between this 31 to 100? Maybe 10, maybe 20. We not know the number. In the first problem, we get number of terms 24. N is equal to given. But here there is no number is given. How many numbers we add? So that is the problem. So we first have to find the value of n, and then we put the value of n there. Because in from that we get A. A is equal to 25 and D is equal to 3. Then what is about A? N. So we have to find the number of terms. So which formula we use? In the first video and second video we learn about the formula, that is an is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. We can put the value of a, we can put the value of d, we can easily calculate n. So put that value here. So two formula use here. So see here, given first, given ap here, very interesting. This is very important example. This is very important. Okay, mark this one, very important for 2 marks. Okay, so here ap, that is 25 plus 28 plus 31 plus so on and up to 100. Okay, so here two formula is used. One formula is to calculate sum, that is Sn is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. Okay, this formula used to calculate sum, and the second formula, that is first use actually, okay, that is what to find value of n. So that is use an is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. First use this formula to find the value of n and the put value here. So let make two parts here. First part I use this formula, an equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. Okay, so we have to, what is an here? So an is equal to 100, right? I write directly the last term is 100, nth term is 100. So what is a here? A is 25. Okay, next what is n? So we have to find it. Okay, so what is d here? See, 28 minus 25, it is 3. 31 minus 20, it is 3. Okay, difference is 3. Right, next, so 100, so 25 plus, let's see here into, make here one time, 25 this side, how much? 75, right? So 25 this side, so we get 3. Okay, so 75 by 3 is equal to n minus 1. Both are same. So 3 2 ja 6, right? 3 2 ja 6, carry 1, 15, 3 5 ja 15. So we get n minus 1 equal to 25. So again, so n equal to 1 this side plus 1, that is 25 plus 1, we get n is equal to 26. Clear? Now let us see, we find the value of this. Therefore, how many terms are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, and in between, how many terms are? 22 terms are there. So that is what, 22 terms plus 4, total 26 terms are there. So you have to find. So simply, we know the value of A is equal to 25 as per given, D is equal to 28 minus 25, that is 3, and N is equal to, we find now, that is 26. Okay, we easily find now Sn. So Sn, how much? 26 is equal to 26 by 2 into A is 25 times, okay, is 25, and plus N is 26 minus 1 into D is how much? D is 3. Okay, now find that 26 by 2 is 13. Okay, then here 50 plus here how much? 25 and here 3. Okay, so how much it is? 50 plus 25 3 times 75. Okay, 75. So 13 into how much it is? 2500, 125. Okay, 125. So now into 125, we get 35 ja 15, carry 1, 3 to 6, 6, 7, and 3 1 ja 3. Okay, 1, 2. Okay, how much is 5? It is 12, it is carry 6, it is 1. So it is about 1625. 1625. So that is what the value of S26. Okay, 1625. So that is what the student solution of the second problem. So very important. Two part here. One part is to find out the value of n, and second part is to find the sn. Okay. So how to find the value of n? Simple, our old formula, the formula number one, that is nth term of an AP. Okay. Sorry, AP. Okay. Find n, then put value here. So this is student about very interesting formula. So pause the video and please copy this solution. Right. Now after this, take example number three. Again, very important example. Example number 3. See here, example 3. Find the sum of first 20 terms of the n is given, okay, no problem, of the AP. Okay, AP whose second term is 8 and fourth term is 14. Okay, 1/4. You see here, and this is another new problem. Here again one problem is there. In this problem, now n is given, but where is about first term and the common difference? That is miss. Right, so no, see here, we know the formula to find the summation, sum of Sn. So we have formula Sn is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. But what problem here? They give only n, that is 21. So what about first term? The first term is not even, only second term given and fourth term given. So by using second and fourth, it is possible to calculate a and d, right? That is very, in the first problem or second video, we learn about that. Okay, how to find D and A by solving the equation. Okay, we first write the second term is A plus D. Eighth term, fourth term is A plus 3D. And then we solve the equation, we cancel AA. And then we get the value of D. And when we put the value of D, we get value of A. Okay, recall that problem. Okay, correct? You got it. Okay, if you got it, means pause the video and solve yourself. And then come and see the solution. Okay, see here. Right. What is second given is here? Second term is given. Okay. So I can write here second term like that. Okay. A2 is equal to how much? A2 is equal to 8. Second term is 8. Okay. And I can write like that. It is A2 is nothing but second term is nothing but A plus D. Right. One less A plus D. 2 minus 1 is 1. A. Now it is equation number 1. Right. Now another one, that is fourth term, that is A4 is equal to A plus, okay, A4 is equal to how much? 14, right? So what is A4? A4 is nothing but A plus 1 less, that is 3D, that is 14, equation number 2. Now we get idea, solve 192. Okay, so solve 192, I solve here because we require space. So A plus D is equal to H and the A plus 3D is equal to 14, right? So now change this as sign. Minus here, plus minus here, plus is minus, so A get cancelled. So minus 2D, okay, 1D minus 3 means minus 2D, and here again minus 6, right? Minus 6, so minus minus get cancelled. Then D is equal to 6 by 2, so D is equal to, that is beautiful, 3. Okay, that is 3. We get the D, and then take any one equation, so put D is equal to 3 in equation 1. Okay, I can take equation 1. So what is equation here? A plus D is equal to 8. Okay, so what is A? What is D? D is equal to 3, 8. So we get A is equal to 8 minus 3. So A is equal to 5. A is equal to 5. Clear? So all is that. So simply put values. So N is equal to how much? N is equal to 21. and n is equal to 21/2, and a is equal to given, that is a we find just now 5, and plus n is equal to 21 given, and minus 1 d we find now, that is what, 3. Okay, so right here do not make decimal, okay, put as it is, not cancel it, it is 11.5, not make decimal here, okay, 20.5, okay, to not make 25.5, write as it, okay, as it is, because final here 2 to get cancelled, okay, so it is 10 here, and plus how much it is, 20 into 3, okay, right, so now 21/2, so 10 plus, okay, 20 into 3, that is 60, okay, how much it is, 21/2 into is 70, right, so 70 cancel, that is 235, so we get 21 into 35, how much it is, okay, how much it is, I can mark here, so how much, that is 30 into 25, 1, 3, 1 and 10, carry 1, 6, 7, okay, 5, 3, 7, so that is about 735, so this is the answer for the question, so 735. So this is another one very important, and this is also board exam question, okay, this is also asked in board exam about for 3 marks, okay, so please practice this type of questions, okay, in the second question they not give n, so we find n, how to find the n, we learn that, and sometime they not give value of a and d, they give such, okay, fifth term, second term, fourth term, by using the solution of equation 1 and 2 like that, you can find d and put value, you find a and then put the values, you get this answer, okay, so this is student about a very interesting, the second third example, okay, so please pause the video and write the solution, okay, now let us see another problem, interesting problem, new one, example number 4, and the next problem also is board example problem which asks in the board examination, okay, again very important, example number 4, see here, example number 4, find the sum of first term of first 25 terms, so n is given, no problem, okay, n is given of an AP, okay, whose nth term, okay, see here, nth term, that is last term, is given by an is equal to 7-3n, see here, totally different, okay, this is another type, so one is clear, so find this, yes, so there is one, this formula, one point is clear, we have to use this formula, okay, if you write like that means we get half marks, we mention the formula, you get half marks, okay, that is we know about sum means this formula must be used. Now let us see, 25 n is given, so a and d again not given here, so by using this it is possible to find a first term and common difference, right, how it is, see, given is an is equal to 7-3n, okay, if I put n is equal to 1, what does it mean, we get first term a1, right, very good, so we get a1 is equal to, when I put n is equal to 1, I get here first term, so a1 is equal to 7 3 into 1, so a1 equal to, that is 7-3, so a1 equal to, that is 4, so a1 is nothing but what, a1 is nothing but itself a, so we get first term. And how we get common difference here? So we know form of common difference, that is d equal to ak plus 1 minus ak, any b succeeding term minus preceding term. So we know about that is formula, I take a2 minus a1. Okay, we know about a1. So what is about a2? Simply one, again use this one. Okay, nth term given, that is here. So find here 2. If n is equal to 2, put n is equal to 2, we get 7-3 into 2. So we get how much? 6, so we get 1, so second term is 1, so easily we can find d here, so d equal to a2 minus a1, so what is a1, a2, that is 1, and it is minus 4, okay, so we get minus 3, So d is equal to minus 3. Again simple. So problem solved, almost problem solved totally. So put the values here. So Sn is equal to n by, so direct from, okay, directly. So what is Sn is what? 25. Okay. So 25 by 2. 2 times of what is A? A is equal to 4. Okay. Plus n is 25 minus 1 into minus 3. Okay, do not forget to write minus 3. So as it is 25, do not make decimal. Okay, h plus 24 into minus 3. Okay, so 25 by 2, 8. So see minus, okay, minus. So see how much 20 minus plus minus here, 23 into 3. 3, 4, 12, carry 1, 2, 3, 6, 72. So we get again. So is how much it is? It is 64, right? 64 and 2 1 minus 64, sorry, and 2 3 2 2, so 32. So minus, so we get minus outside, so 25 into 32, how much it is? Okay, see how much it is. 25 minus 32, it is equal to minus 800. See here, very simple new type problem but very easy. Okay, so that is three type we observe here. In one type, n is absent. In second type problem, we observe that a and d both are absent. And how do you find? By solving the equation. Okay, and here also a, d, a, d is not there. So that is n term is given. So how by using n term find? Any number you find. If you know about the n term, any number you find. Put one is, n is equal to 1, we get first term. Put n is equal to 2, we get second term. Put n is equal to 3, we get third term, any term. So I record only 1 and 2 terms. Okay, why? Because of here first term is useful, and then for the 2 second term, why we require? Because to find d. So that is why I can find a1 and a2, and by a1 give me value of here a, and the a2 give me the value of d, because a2 minus a1 we get the difference, common difference, that is 1, that is common difference minus 3. I put the values, I get minus 25 into, I can take minus outside, so minus 25 and 32, we get 800, right? So this is another very important problem. So hope you understand this one. So again, write down the whole problem. Okay, now take about the problem number 5th. Okay, the 5th problem, again, problem number 5, example 5, right? So see here, if the, again new type, if the nth term of an AP, again nth term is given, okay, that is 2n plus 1, okay, that is an given, find the sum of first n terms, okay, n terms of the AP. Okay, means we have to put n as it is, okay, not change the value of n. So again, simple one, try yourself, pause the video and find the solution. Okay, pause my video and try yourself, and then re-watch the again video for the solution. Okay, right, 1 2 3 pause. Okay, I think you got the answer. What is answer? You find the answer of n term. Okay, so let us see your answer is correct or not. Okay, so given is what? An is given. Okay, nth term is given, that is an is equal to 2a plus 1. So we have to find sum of n terms. Okay, we have to find sum of n term, that is this formula. We have to use this formula. Okay, again see, we want a and d, we not want n, because they give only find n term itself, they not give to find n. So we require n terms. Okay, put n as it is. So only we require a and d. So how to find a and d? Simple, just we do for a, we put n is equal to 1, and for d we put n is equal to 2. Okay, right, I hope you get correct answer. Okay, so an is equal to 2a plus 1, so a1 is equal to 2 into 1 plus 1, so a1 equal to, that is 2 plus 1, so a1 equal to 3. okay, itself multiply but A. Okay, now A2 we find, so A2 times of 1, therefore A2 is equal to 4 plus 1, then A2 is equal to 5. Right, now find value of D, that is D2 A2 minus A1, so A2 is 5 minus 3, so we get 2, so D is equal to 2. Okay, solution is finished. So therefore Sn is equal to n by 2 to what is A? A is equal to, sorry, wait here, A is equal to A1 is but 3, right? A is equal to 3, okay, plus next n as it is, okay, because we find only n terms, so n minus 1 in n minus 1 into d, d is equal to, that is 2 plus 2, okay, so n by 2 as it is, so it is 6, and here n minus, okay, into 2 into n, that is 2n, and minus 2, we get n by 2 is equal to, so 4, 6 minus 2 is equal 4, so 2n, I write 2n plus first, and then 6 minus 2 is plus 4, so 2 common here, so n into 2 common means how much, n plus 2. See here 2n and 2 to the 4, same 2 common, so 2 to get cancelled, so we get n into n plus 2, so into n, n square, then n into 2, 2n, so that is what Sn. Okay, so that is the answer. Okay, so that is the answer is correct, n square plus 2n. See here, or also we write a plus 2n plus, but first is bigger value, bigger degree, so n square plus 2n, right? So this is what the another type of question here, right? So hope you understand all these points, right? And take another last question, which is in which we use L, okay, that is all last question. Sn is equal to n by 2 into a plus L, one is there formula, that also use now one problem. In the next video we can take more problems, okay? So for today, last video, last problem is number 6. Let take last problem. Okay, so see here, find, I can use red marker here, find the sum of all two digits odd, see here, odd positive numbers. See here, it is very interesting, and again board exam question, okay, see here, what is find the sum of numbers is not given, only trick is given, two digit number, which type of digit is this? It must be odd. So see here, one is odd number, but it is single digit, we require two digit number, so up to 9 single digit, 10 double digit, but 10 is a even number, 11, right, 11 is odd number, after 12 even number, 13, okay, 15, 17, again so on, that is last is 99, last is 99 odd or even, odd number, because it is not divisible by 2 completely, so this is the sequence, they are not given, but only they give sentence, two digit. Such problems in the next video I solve. Okay, in such video, next problem, we have solved most of the question of this concept like that. Okay, so this is one trailer here. Two digit number, which type of number? Two digit, okay. And what is the property of that number? And that number must be positive and odd. So see here, the all positive and all odd. 11 is not divided by 2, 13 is not divided by 2. It is double digit odd number. So see here what we get. So we get how many number? We get A is equal to 11. And D is equal to itself 3, how much? 13 minus 11, it is 2. Okay, and the last term is given. Okay, that is L or An. You take An, that is 99. So what about N? Number of terms? Not given. Number of terms is not given. How many terms are there up to 99? Here we write only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Again, next, in between that. So we have to find first N. So how do you find N? Right. By using formula, an is equal to a plus n minus 1 to d. So we get idea. So pause the video and write the solution. Okay, then see the answer. Okay, hope you get the answer, right? So let us see. Check your answer here. So I can find the value of n here. So an is equal to a plus n minus 1 into d, right? So what is an? an is anything but l. Okay, I can make here for simplicity l equal to, if you get, forget it, okay, l is nothing but 99. Okay, so what is a? A is 11 plus n. We have to find what is d. D is 2. 99 minus 1, take this side, minus 11, and then 2, n minus 1 into 2. Okay, take again here. Okay, take here, 99 minus 11 is 88, right? And here, divide by 2, that is n minus 1. Then 44 plus 1 is equal to n, I can make directly, okay? So, n equal to 45. 45 terms are between that one. Okay, total 45. If you write, start to write 11, 13, 15, 17, 19, 21, up to how many 99? So, we get how many numbers are there? 45 numbers are there. So, means we have to find out all 45 numbers. So, n is equal to 45, correct? So, n 45 is equal to 45 by 2. I use this formula. Where is n is equal to? Okay, you know formula? N by 2. 2a. A is equal to, where is a? A is equal to this one, 11. And plus n is equal to 45 minus 1, and the d is equal to 2. D is equal to 2. Okay, so make, not make decimal as it is, if not cancel, put as it is. So it is 22 plus, it is 44 into 2, right? Now 45 divided by 2, 22 plus double is 88. So again 45 by 2, again how much, 90 110, correct? Plus 2, 90 plus 20, 110. So 55. So how much? 45 into 55, calculate 45 into 55, we get 2475. Okay, if you multiply the 45 into 55, we get 2475. So see here, this is another very important problem. So in this video, actually we are solve 4-6 problems on SN, and very important problems. Somewhere N is absent, somewhere A absent, D absent, and somewhere N terms are given, and sometimes itself a sequence absent, only trick is given. So how we take all this? So we today we learn here. So one point is clear, in finding the sum of the terms of an AP, we sometime also use this formula. Okay, means that is AN formula is very important. If you not know about that one, so please watch the first video and second video, and then come to watch this video. Okay, without studying this formula, we not understand this one. So please perfect this first. AN is equal to A plus N minus 1 to D, and then come to the SN, because in SN also we use AN. Okay, to finding A value, so N value. For finding the value of n, so very important formula it is. Okay, so hope you understand this whole video, and these are a very important problem we tackle here. So in the next video, we are take another more problems. Okay, most important and most frequently asked examination problems. Okay, in the next video. So again, meet in the next video. I say thank you so much for watching this video, and in the next video we can take very important problems on summation. Okay, so take care. Bye.